We are in a cenote in the Yucatan. Hey, Joshua, what is the name of this cenote?
Sakaktun.
That is Joshua. Joshua, our guide and photographer. Sakaktun. What's that? We'll find out. Nah, that's all right. I'll just keep it up. Not a problem. So this is a cenote or a sinkhole that's connected with the underground river channel, the longest network of underground rivers in the world. And we're gonna actually go swimming in the cave. That's why we have our wetsuit and our life vests on there. So this is where we go in. Very pretty, and you can see the light coming through from above. Alright, so we are going into the cenote. Is it cold?
It's actually not bad.
Here we go.
This water is very heavy on calcium because it went through the limestone. So if I turn my lamp on to turn on the surface, you see all this dust on the surface. Do you see? It's so calcium carbonate on the surface that the water leaves after it evaporates. Inside this column, there is a root of a tree that is still drinking water because the limestone is so porous, it basically has a breathable armor. So all the trees want to have their roots inside the water so they can drink whenever they want. And then they have exponential growth.
Wow, look at that. Wow. Yoshua, what's the name of the cenote again?
Sak-ak-tun.
Wow.
So, what we are looking at right now is how Mother Nature creates a cenote. This huge root we have in front of us, at some point was a tiny, thin root that went through a small hole. Eventually, it arrived to the water and it started becoming thicker, heavier, bigger, until it collapsed the thinnest part of that surface, opened this hole, and then with the opening, light came, and with light, life came. The bats that we can actually see when flying around, the bats brought the seeds for the little trees that are growing in the center of this little oasis paradise island.
Wow.
Which is fantastic.
And fantastic.
Very cool spot to do some landscape photography.
Right. All right, time for photo mode. So we are continuing to explore the depths of Sak-ak-tun cenote in the Yucatan. Mexico, and we are wading in an underground network of rivers. There's bats flying around. It's really cool.
Mr. Keita, look what happened when I turned my light on here. Look,
okay,
at
turn.
This structure.
Wow.
This stalactite looks like a Medusa or a somebody from Star Wars or. This place, really, when I am here, I feel like I'm in another planet. The structure seems to defy gravity.
It does.
Something really, really special.
Fantastic. That is our wonderful guide, Yoshua.
Hello. And look at this huge boulder here, Mr. Keita.
Yes.
All these rocks, they are here because there was the root of a tree that poked a hole. Therefore, more water started coming through. For thousands of years, created all these rocks. And then the bats brought the seeds for this little.
Oh, that's the fertilizer. Oh my gosh.
They brought the seeds and they fertilized it. But these plants will not grow much more because they have a very limited supply of sun. Actually, if you look, the leaves are not that green, they're kind of yellowish.
Yeah.
Because of the lack of sun. They cannot photosynthesize as they would love to.
Incredible how nature really.
Here,
yeah.
They are growing towards the sun. You can see, trying to fight for their lives. They don't have a great fate here, they will not grow too much. But these particular cenote on this side, is known for jaguars to come and drink water, as well as other wild animals. It has a lot of soft soil and easy access for animals, so it's often common to find birds.
Oh, look at that bird.
You see bird?
Yeah.
That's a tiger heron.
Tiger heron, yeah. So is this the end of the cenote?
This is this part, the end of this part, but we will go back to where we came from, leave the cameras, and then we'll go deeper into
it. Oh, is that right? Oh, yeah. Wonderful. So this is where we came from. Sa actun cenote.